Unfortunately, technology is not on our side today. So in 5 minutes, I will try to do my best because I talked to Shlomi. We had several conversations on these topics. We are in constant touch and also in preparation for today's talk. And I'll try to sort of speak on his behalf, hoping that I do represent him. One of the main insights Shlomi has is counterintuitive when it comes to how we see Hamas and how decisions are made there. And he claims that we have an understanding that things are done there in very organized fashion, when in fact, it's not exactly that way. And he says that both in the March of the Return and also in the Kites, as a more contemporary example, there was no sort of organized maneuver, organized step. There was a sort of a utilization of an opportunity, seizing an opportunity. And in terms of some of the senior leaders of Hamas, it is a kind of development that they decided to harness in order to promote their own goals. And their main two goals are, as Shlomi sees it, are first of all to alleviate the pressure in the Gaza Strip, both because they feel the pressure of the local population, because they feel more committed. The current Hamas leadership feel more committed, more sensitive toward the local population, and also because they know that at the end of the day, their future in the Gaza theater and in the Palestinian arena is conditioned upon their ability to improve the situation. That's one thing. And the second thing, which has to do with the end of what I just said, is the political struggle, the kind of political fist fight between Hamas and Fatah in the Palestinian theater. And so the March of the Return over the last 14 weeks or so, and the matter of the Kites, both are supposed to promote these two goals and advance them, because they understand that Israel can be pressured. They understand, they read the Israeli discourse, they understand that there is a clear statement by the political echelon that they have no intention to go into a campaign that at the end of the day will topple Hamas. And they also identify a sort of reservation, which is backed up by statements made by the military when it comes to a ground campaign, a campaign with boots on the ground. So they're trying to create a new equation where by they are going to a far extreme, further than what they've done until now, and by reaching that sort of far extreme, they will be exerting pressure on the Israeli population of the Gaza envelope to embarrass both the political and military echelons, and I'm talking about the Kites here, both the military and political echelons, and at the end of the day, this will create enough of a pressure on the Israeli decision makers so as to create or reach the arrangement that they are seeking. They want an arrangement that is mediated by the Egyptians and will leave them sovereign in the Gaza Strip, bringing about an improvement infrastructurally and economically, but also maintaining their military strength, which is really the basis of their influence there. Aside from these two goals, Shlomi, in his conversations with his sources in the Gaza Strip, with Hamas people there, identifies, first of all, that there is more than one sort of logic behind their operations or an operative sort of approach. There is no one monolithic leadership. There are disagreements among Hamas leaders for what should happen, and there are also sort of fistfights about that. Hamas is also under the impact of Egypt quite substantially, and they are in a sort of catch 22 kind of thing, because they are at the end of the day also left to the mercy of Egypt and the Rafah passage. So if they want to, they open the Egyptians, and if they don't, they close it. So they also feel that their struggle through the kites against Israel is accepted by the Egyptians as well. It is something that the Egyptians are accepting of, and they believe that in this way they are impacting public opinion. Shlomi said he's not sure whether they even use the word cognitive campaign, but they are trying to impact Israel opinion, and they do identify Israeli society as a democratic society where the civil society have a say, where their frustration and criticism could at the end of the day impact the political echelon as well. And if I were to sum up what I understood from Shlomi's insights about Hamas in the Gaza Strip, they believe that these moves are the kind that demonstrate control, and they believe that at the end of the day, if we're talking about cognition and cognitive warfare, then the Israeli collective cognition is against a war with Gaza, and therefore they can continue to provoke Israel until finally they will manage to bring it to where they want Israel to be. And so at the end of the day, they perceive this campaign as a success, and Shlomi says that perhaps it would be a misperception if we're talking about that in terms of cognition. I hope that I've managed to convey and reflect what Shlomi thinks. Thank you very much.